Good morning, Bethel Chapel and Hopewell AME Church and our virtual family and friends. Welcome to our online services. We are so glad you chose to worship with us. May today's worship encourage, inspire, and uplift you. Let's get ready to worship.
Austin tripping on this restless sea of time. Clap your hands, we'll understand it better. Bye and bye, come on. We are tossed and driven on this restless sea of time. Summer skies and howling tempest, all succeed in bright sunshine. In the land of perfect day, when the lakes that roll away, and you're understanding better, by my perspective, we are often destitute of the things that life demands. Want a food and want a shelter, thirsty hills and barren land. We are trusting in the Lord and according to God's word, and we'll understand it better by and by. The chorus, come on. By and by, when the morning comes, all the saints of God will be gathering home. We will tell the story. To that blessed promised land, but he guides us in his eye, and we'll follow till we die, for we'll understand it better by and by. Clap your hands and say, by and by. Oh, when the morning comes, all the saints of God will be gathering home. We will tell how we overcome.
Well, praise the Lord. Good morning, my brothers and sisters. It's Pastor Trent Ogilvie, Pastor Bethel Chapel and Hopewell AME Church. I am delighted to have you join with us for worship on this Sunday. I tell you what, I know your Christmas was blessed. I know that through it all, God has ministered to your spirit. Amen. There is nothing that can separate us from his love. No pandemic, no coronavirus, no bombs going off in Nashville. There is nothing, amen, that can separate us from God's love. We're thankful that God loves us. Amen. And we know that as God loves us, we continue to love God with all of our soul, with all of our mind, our strength, and love our neighbor as we love ourselves. We are thankful today to be able to rejoice together and come one more time. Amen. Saying, praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace and your mercy. God, we ask now that you descend your presence, God, that is with us, God, at all times. Send your presence that gives us comfort, that gives us peace, that heals us, God, that restores us, that protects us. God, you are a shelter. God, even from the stormy blast, God, you are our eternal home. God, you are everything that we need you to be. And we trust you with all of our heart today. Yes, God, when we trust you with all of our heart and lean not to our own understanding, in all our ways we acknowledge you, you will direct our path. Direct us, oh God, in the way that we should go. God, even as we end out this year of 2020, we've had some difficulties. Lord, we have some trials that we have had to endure. God, we've had some times in which we have cried and had to deal with grief due to the loss of loved ones. God, we're praying now that you would restore unto us, God, the joy of our salvation. God, you would minister unto us and let us know that through every test, there is a testimony. In 2020, God, there have been a lot of tests, but God, we've got a greater testimony that you are still God, that you're still up on the throne, that you still rule and super rule. You still can make a way out of no way. You're still God, and we lift your name. We glorify you today, God. We magnify you above, hallelujah, everything that's going on. My soul, Lord, will make a boast of the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us rejoice and exalt his name together. God, we love you. We thank you for what you're doing in our midst. Bless this time of worship in each person, in each household. God, make a way as only you can. Protect us, oh God, even today as a church family, as a people, God, protect us by the power of your mighty hand. We thank you and we trust you, God. We love you and we know that through it all, your grace is sufficient in all things. We magnify you, we exalt you, and we rejoice in the matchless, powerful name of Jesus Christ, the one in whom we celebrate during this Christmas season. We thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Our scripture reading comes from Psalms 91. Reading from the New International Version. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him I will trust. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say the Lord is my refuge and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you. No disaster will come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the cobra, and you will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call on me and I will answer. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Psalms 91, the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. I tell you what, today is going to be a wonderful blessing. We minister and we thank God for his word and for his presence. As we go into this time of worship, I have a very special treat for you. Pastor Christi Armstrong is going to deliver our message on today. And we're thankful for her, for her husband, Deacon John Armstrong, and for the family. We're thankful for them, been friends down through the years. And I am so delighted to have her come share this wonderful word with you today. Hear the word of God as we continue to worship together. Amen.
Now I had many tears of sorrows. I had questions for tomorrow. There's been times I didn't know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave me blessed consolation that my trials come to only make me strong. And through it all, oh, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. Yes, I've learned to trust in God.
Oh, I sing
through it all,
through it all.
Through it all,
through it all. I've been lots of places, and I've seen lots of faces. There's been time I've been left so all alone, so all alone. And in those dark and lonely hours, oh, those precious lonely hours, Jesus let me know what I was his own. That's the reason I say
through it all.
Yes, I've learned to trust
in God.
I'm telling you, through it all,
through it all,
hey, I've learned
to depend upon His word.
Say it again, say it again. Through it all,
through it all,
it's been some hard time.
Hey, I've learned to trust in Jesus.
You're the one I love.
I've learned to trust in God.
See
through it all.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Through it all.
Through it all, I've learned to depend upon His word. God for the mountains, and I thank Him for the valleys, and I thank Him for the storms that He brought me through. And if I've never had a problem, I would know that God, He could solve it. I would know it, His faith, His word. That's the reason I sing
through it all.
I'm telling you,
through it all,
I've learned to trust in Jesus. It's been a little bit hard, but I've learned
to trust in God.
Through it all,
through it all,
through the tears, through the tears,
through it all.
Today, give an honor to God, who is the head of the church and who is the head of my life and from whom all blessings flow. I thank the Lord for this great opportunity here at Bethel AME Church, where Pastor Reverend Trent Ogilvy is the honorable pastor, and also of Hopewell AME Church. I thank for this opportunity to come and share a word with the people of God. If we ever needed the Lord before, we sure do need Him now. So I thank God for this opportunity. Amen. When I got the phone call on this week and asked to share the Sunday message, amen, the first thing came into my heart, I've got to be honest with you, is experiencing peace. Amen. Because throughout 2020, it seemed that there has been trouble on every side and on every hand. And on the TV, you would look at the TV, and on your jobs and in the financials, racial, unrest. But I thank God for experiencing peace. And peace is not found within the world. It's not found on TV. It's not found in the newspaper, on the internet. Peace is found in the Word of God. So I would like to ask each and every one of you to go to the Word today. And I want to share this word. I don't plan to be before you long. Amen. But I believe God has a word for us on today. Our message will be coming from the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 22. Amen. I'm going to pause for just a minute. And anyone that may be watching, that they can get their tablet or their Bibles. I will be reading today from the King James Version. Amen. And this is a parable. Jesus tells the parable of a wedding feast. Amen. Jesus tells the parable of a wedding feast. And it's coming from Matthew chapter 22. And while everyone is looking, amen, and preparing our hearts and mind for this word, amen, we can't do anything apart from prayer. Amen. God of grace and glory. Father God, we bow our heads today before you, oh God. Father God, we are thanking you for watching over us from our early existence right down to this present moment. Father God, we thank you that you look beyond our faults and you solve our every need. Father God, we thank you for getting up this morning and having a mind to come out to your house of worship one more time. Father God, as we get ready to go into your word, Father God, give us an ear and a heart to hear your word, but not to be hearers only, but to be doers of your word. Father God, we don't want to forget our brothers and sisters in Nashville, Father God, experiencing the bomb. Father God, we don't want to forget the frontline workers that has continued to fight a faithful fight against this pandemic. We don't want to forget, Father God, the ones that sit laying on their beds of affliction. Father God, we lift them up to you right now. We're asking you in your wisdom, in your providence, in your sovereignty, and in your own time, Father God, to dry up this pandemic, Father God. Father God, we thank you, Lord, Father God, that everything is as well with us as it is. Father God, we thank you for allowing us to see another Christmas holiday and a Christmas season, for Jesus is the reason for the season. And Father God, as we get this close to experiencing another year, Father God, we just want to thank you, Father God, for everything. Father God, is everything been as well with us as it is? Father God, as we get ready to go into this word, Father God, let Christi decrease and you increase within me. Father God, speak through me, Father God, that your word will go forth with power and with might. It will be rightly divided and fully understood. This is my prayer in Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen. Amen. The Gospel of St. Matthew, amen, chapter 22, verse 1, and it reads as follows. And Jesus answered and spake unto them again by parables. We know that a parable is an earthly story with a heavenly meaning, and said, verse 2, the kingdom of heaven is like unto a certain king which made a marriage for his son, and sent forth his servants to call them that was bidden to the wedding, and they would not come. I want to stop right there, and if I was going to use a topic, amen, on today for this particular passage of scripture that has been in my spirit for a month or so now, it would be save the date. Amen. Save the date. Amen. A wedding, a lot of preparation had goes into planning and preparing for a wedding. As we see in the first couple of verses, amen, it says a certain king, amen, which made a marriage for his son, and sent forth his servants to call them that was invited to the wedding, but they would not come. Again, he sent forth other servants, saying, tell them which are bidden, invited, behold, I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and my fatlings are killed, and all things are ready. Come unto the marriage. Amen. On last night, as I began to Christmas night, and me and my family, and me and Deacon Armstrong, we began to talk about this particular passage of scripture. A lot of preparation goes into a wedding. I was blessed on last Sunday to be able to see my niece, amen, my first niece to marry, amen. And I began to sit there, amen, and thought about, my mind rolled back to when me and Dick and Armstrong got married, and we've been married 33 years. Amen. But when you get ready to plan a wedding, amen, you have to get the minister, the preacher, or the pastor on who's going to marry. It's good, amen. And I would advise for you to have counseling before you have marriage. You have to get the venue, the place, the church, the event center on where the marriage is going to be held. You got to make sure that you got a proper accommodations. Amen. Is it wheelchair, handicap accessible, that you will be able to get everyone in? If you're going to have food, you have to find your right caterers and the music and the bridesmaids and their dresses and the grooms. And don't forget the flowers and the rings. And all of these things go into preparing a great wedding. Amen. But as we look at this passage here, as I said earlier, it's a parable. It's an earthly story with a heavenly meaning. There's been great preparation to go in for you and for me to spend our lives, amen, in eternity when we leave this walk of life. Amen. God looked down through time and he brought his son, amen, down through 40 and two generations. Amen. He came and he walked upon this earth 33 years. Amen. And, amen. He came, amen, down through sin and shame, amen, and he went and died on the cross, amen, but he didn't stay dead, amen. On that third appointed morning, he rose with all power in his hand, came back, amen, and walked among his disciples, amen, preached, amen, and then he ascended up on high. So great preparation, just like went into the marriage feast, great preparation, amen, has gone for you and I to be saved. But those preparations is an invitation. Amen. Let's talk about the invitation, amen, when you receive the invitation in the mail. Most invitations, amen, they're on beautiful cardstock, amen. Sometimes the invitation, when I marry, it would be an envelope within an envelope, amen. It'd be a little piece of white tissue, a little veil, amen, over the writing of the invitation. It would be you are quarterly invited, amen, to the name of the parents, amen, the pride that goes into that to be able to extend to you, amen, the invitation to the wedding. Sometimes a wedding is actually a little package, amen. Sometimes there's a picture in there of the couple. Sometimes there's a card in there, stamps have to be posted, amen, and say RSVP. We need you to reserve your place at the wedding. We need you to save the date. Amen. That's what you and I've got to do, because one of these days we have got to leave this walk of life, and there's no harm in moving. Amen. If we've made preparations and if we have saved the date. But verse number 5, as we move on, and amen, don't plan to be here all day. Amen. But the point, this is a very powerful passage of scripture, one that have stayed in my heart, and I just keep going back to Matthew 22. It says, verse 5 says, but they made light of it. Amen. That's another point that I would like to share with you today. A lot of people make light of an invitation. Amen. And if the invitation says, amen, a certain attire is formal or all white, sometimes we make light of invitations. Amen. And we look at an invitation and I'm not going. Amen. What time is it? Amen. I'm not buying anything special to wear to them. We make light not only of certain invitations, but this is an honor. Children of God, amen, saints, brothers and sisters in Christ, when you are invited, when somebody takes time to get your name and your official Mr. and Mrs., amen, and your stamps and do all of these things, order expensive cardstock invitations, like raise letters, amen, and mail it out to you, this is an honor. Sometimes we put the invitation down, amen. Sometimes it tells where the, amen, her dishes are recorded, amen. She's got some things set aside at Target and all of the different places where you can get a dish. But we lay these things aside, and as the Bible says, they made light of it. I talked to my son, amen. I said, talk to me about making light of things. He said, you don't take it seriously. That's what that means when you make light of something. Oh, we make light. He says, some people make light of running water. Everybody does not have a faucet. He looked at me in their homes where we can go over to a faucet and turn the faucet on and water comes out. We take those things for what? Granted. I'm guilty. I let the water run while I brush my teeth. That's actually wasteful. When you're washing your vegetables sometimes, we let the water, we take things for granted and we think things will always be there. What else do we take for granted? Amen. The privilege of riding in a car and driving. Amen. We should never text. Lord have mercy. And drive. Amen. If you got your phone on you, you should know that that's dangerous. One look away from the steering wheel when you're driving down the road, one text, one ding, you hit it. Oh, I can answer that real quick. I can say yes real quick. One thing like that could cause somebody to lose their life. We take these things, warning labels, for granted. Some of us, now in COVID-19, we took gatherings for granted, going to weddings. Some of us would be glad to get to go now. Amen. Because we took those things, we took going to church for granted. So here we look, amen, our marriage for granted. Our loved ones, they'll always be there for granted. So they made light of it and went their ways. One, it says, to his farm. And another, to his merchandise, to his business. And the remnant took his servants. Amen. God has servants today in the form of ministers and preachers and reverends and teachers and elders. Amen. And entreated them spitefully and slew them. But when the king heard thereof, amen, he was wroth. And he sent forth his armies and destroyed those murderers and burned up their cities. Then said he to his servants, the wedding is ready. Have you saved the date? Are you prepared to go in to the wedding? Amen. But they that which were bidden was not worthy. Verse 9 says, go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as you find shall find, bid them to come. So the intended guests, amen, it said earlier, the fatted oxen, amen, and the fatted calf. It takes a while, as me and Deacon Armstrong, to fatten up that calf and set those animals apart to prepare all of this wonderful food. And as we continue last night to have our lesson at home, there's another point, amen, I want to share with you, amen, before I get to the end, amen, of this wonderful message. Everything was free, amen. I could see sometimes, amen, if you want to say, I'm not going, amen, if there's admission at the door, amen. But everything, amen, I'm so glad. I believe there's somebody here today that's glad, amen, that salvation, amen, is free, amen. When you got the invitation, amen, you didn't have to, amen, RSV, amen, with $150, amen. You didn't have to RSV, amen, with this amount of money. All Jesus is asking for us is to come, amen. The table is spread, amen. There's a feast going on, amen. The fatted calf, the oxen, all the finer things of life is right here. But all you got to do, amen, is save the date, amen. Live for me, amen. Do the things that God has called for you to do, amen. So when the ones that was invited refused, disrespectful, it said that some was actually just a rebel. They would not come. He sent his servants. He said, verse 9 says, go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as you shall find, bid to the marriage. Just let them come on in. Let them come on in, because this is a king, and he prepared this great feast for his son, his beloved son, in whom he was well pleased. Verse 10 says, so those servants went out as they was instructed into the highways and gathered together all as many as they found, both bad. I begin to look at that. Had to look, Pastor, open. Both bad and good. And the wedding was furnished with guests.
And when the king came, now everybody here. Amen. Everybody is here. Now the king came in to greet his guest. In verse 11, it says, he saw there a man, Lord have mercy, amen, which had not on a wedding garment. This is showing us God's grace. This is showing us his mercy. This parable is showing us just how good, amen, God is, that he prepared all of this for us, amen. When we was bad and when we wasn't doing the things, it says, while we was yet sinners, Christ died, amen. We didn't do anything to deserve it, but all of this was prepared for us, amen. All we got to do, amen, is come, amen. But we gotta come right, amen. It was a man there, and he had not on a wedding garment. And he said unto him, I like what he said to him. He said, friend, how camest thou in hither not having a wedding garment? Did you not know that you was coming to the wedding? Did you not know that this was a prepared event? Amen. How did you get in and you did not change? How did you get in and you did not change? God is good and he's merciful, but we have got to change if we're going to the wedding feast. We have got to change, amen, if we're going to spend eternity with him. Amen. He said, friend, how camest thou in hither, having not on the right attire, having not on the wedding garment? And he was speechless. I had to look at that. He didn't have an answer. Sometimes when we take things for granted and we make light of things, amen, we think, I'm just gonna go there for a minute. Sometimes we think we'll get by. We think it'll be okay, and we think maybe I may cause too much of attention draw to myself. But he was speechless when the king come over and called him, friend, how did you get in? Why did you come to the wedding, amen, and you don't have on a wedding garment? And he was speechless. Then said the king to his servants, bind him hand and foot and take him away and cast him into outer darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. For many are called, but few are chosen. Amen, amen. I thank God for this parable. Amen. And the meaning it's saying to us is save the date. Amen. Us believers, amen, we've had a great invitation. We've received a great invitation, amen, when Jesus died on the cross for all of our sins. Amen. But he wants us to come. Amen. I would just like to encourage you in these times. Amen. Spend time with God. Pray every day. Amen. Do your devotionals. Amen. Read your Sunday school lesson. Amen. Get on your knees and study the word of God. Amen. Just because some cannot assemble at the church, amen, that does not give us the opportunity to not do the things that we should do. Amen. Because God is watching. Amen. And we must save the day, because one of these days, and we don't know when it is, amen, we have got to leave this walk of life, and we must spend eternity somewhere. Amen. So we just want to be prepared in that time. As I get ready to close, amen, I want to read a story, amen, in my Sunday school lesson that touched my heart. It says, Called to Be an Heir. It's titled, Called to Be an Heir. Both are single mothers with three young children, two boys and one girl. Both get their children to church most every Sunday. Both are usually dressed neatly themselves and have their children dressed neatly as well. One of the few differences between the two is how their children behave, especially in church, and how each mother reacts. Janie takes quite a bit of time to instruct her children at home. She states clearly what she expects of her children while they're at church. Those times when they do get a little bit out of line or a little bit noisy, she makes direct eye contact with her children, and most of the time that always gets the message across. Stop acting up or you will suffer the consequences when we get home. Usually, that's enough. Ethel takes a different approach. Her instruction is in the moment. When her children whisper too loudly during church service, she whispers louder than they do, telling them to pipe down and to straighten up. If that isn't enough, she might even give them an open-handed smack real loud on the thigh right in the middle of church, which sends a clapping echo throughout the congregation. And you can see, Ethel is disciplining her children in church, as she oftentimes does. And her discipline reoccurs Sunday after Sunday. The two mothers' approaches are different, and you likely prefer one over the other. But so are the children's responses to their mothers are different. Why do some parents have to raise their voices for their children to hear them, while others can just look at you and get the message across? I thought about us with the invitation. Why do some of us get the invitation? Amen. And we put it in a place and we RSVP and we buy us a piece of china or a towel and we make it to that wedding and with pride that they wanted me here, and some disregard. Maybe it's how we have learned to listen or not to listen to instructions. That carries over into our spiritual lives, begging the question, what does Jesus, the exalted heir of all things, have to do to get us to listen to him? And I would like to encourage you to save the date. Father God, we bow our heads. O Lord our God, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Father God, I humble myself, Father God, at your word, Father God. Father God, just let us again not be just hearers of your word, but be doers of your word. Father God, you don't yell. Father God, you talk to us a lot of times, not in the storm, not in the rain, not in the thunder, not always in the lightning, but in a still, quiet, small voice. And Father God, when you tug on us and you whisper something that we must do, Father God, let us get in a hurry. Let us get busy and be about our Father's business. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for this time in your word. We thank you, Lord, for this parable that's been left on record for us, Father God, that we can look at Matthew 22, and behooves each and every one of us to save the day. Father God, if it's something I should have said and didn't, Father God, we ask a blessing on the hearers, but most of all, the doers of your most holy and righteous word. These things I pray and ask it all in Jesus' name.
Well, praise the Lord, my brothers and sisters. We're thankful for you joining us and coming and sharing with us for this another worship experience here at Bethel Chapel and Hopewell AME Church. I'm Pastor Trent Ogilvie. Thankful for you sharing with us today. Thankful for Pastor Armstrong and for her blessing our heart with the word of God. And we're thankful for each of you who have joined us and continue to worship with us wherever you are. We're thankful that you think enough of us to allow us to come into your home and the word of God to come into your heart. And we're just so delighted. And so we want you to know that wherever you are somebody. You are God's child. Amen. God has not forgotten about you. God has you in the palm of his hand. And there is nothing that you go through that God cannot handle. Amen. It is revealed to us and we believe it. It is true. Amen. All things are possible to those who believe. Amen. All things are possible to those who believe. Listen, a few announcements as we get ready to close our broadcast for today. Listen, I want to thank those who take it a part of themselves to make sure that we have this wonderful presentation every week. I want to thank Michaela Ogilvie, my daughter, for her work with the media with making sure our preparations are done each and every Sunday. I thank God for each and every one of you, our officers, amen, for your prayers, for you being there to support this great work of the church. It takes all of us together, amen. We are outside of the four walls, but we're doing the will of God, amen, the way God wants us to do it, amen. When God is moving, amen, all we got to do is just be obedient and do what God has for us to do. I want to remind you, coming up this week on Thursday, December 31st, we'll have our watch night service, 11 p.m. You'll find it on Facebook Live. The Americana Area AME Alliance is going. Look it up on Facebook. We'll be having a watch night service, and it's going to be a wonderful time. Pastor Tanya Mason, who is the pastor of Canaan AME Church, will be the preacher for our watch night service. Come, let's worship together. Let's thank God as we end out this year of 2020 and we're going into the year of 2021. We're expecting greater things to come and God to be glorified. He brought us through this, amen, this year, amen. And we're thankful that God is going to do greater things in the year of 2021. Listen, I want to put before you just a little special giveaway. We're thankful for Pastor Armstrong and we know John Christopher owns Mom's the Word, and we're going to be giving away 5 bouquets of flowers. All you got to do is just type to the number on your screen. That's 931-263-0707. That's 931-263-0707. I want you to type, "I still believe." You remember when we started this year, I passed out these cards to the membership of Bethel Chapel. And I said, this year of 2020 is going to be unique like none other. We got to make a decision. We got to follow God's vision and we got to receive the provision. 2020, I still believe. I believe God and I believe Mark 9:23, as Jesus said, everything is possible to those who believe. All right, type it in, text it to us. We're going to announce on the first Sunday in 2021 our winners. Also, you'll be receiving communion packages so that we can share communion together on the first Sunday in the brand new year of 2021. God bless you. We love you. Thank you so much for worshiping with us. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost is our prayer. God bless you. Have a wonderful, wonderful day.